Dunk here, and today I'm going to show you how you can reclaim rent fees on the Solana blockchain. And if you don't know what rent fees are, buckle down because I'm going to explain everything to you. By the end of this video, you're going to be able to connect your wallet, see what tokens you have paid rent for that you no longer are using, and then reclaim those fees. And before we get started, if you wouldn't mind just smashing that like button, hitting subscribe, and ringing the bell, it really does help tell the algorithm to show these videos to more people. And if you think that this is cool, I bet other people will too. And one more quick reminder, I'm just showing you what I'm doing. I'm not a financial advisor, so make sure that you are always doing your own research. All right, let's get into it. So I'm going to be showing you how to do this with the Phantom wallet on Solana. If you don't have the wallet yet, just go to phantom.app, install it in a compatible browser, or you could do this on your mobile device, but I'm showing you how to do it on desktop, but the principle is pretty much the same. You would just need to go through the wallet browser. I have this wallet that I've installed, and you can see right here, I have Gary Coin, Solana, USDC, and then some other things that I don't necessarily need in this wallet, some coins that have kind of gone dead. See, they don't really have any real liquidity behind them, just maybe have a little bit of dust in this wallet. And every time that there's a little bit of dust in the wallet, like these things, like see this supporter coin, which is pretty much empty, there's no liquidity backing it, I might as well just burn this token or get rid of this token and get my rent back. I don't want to get rid of everything in this wallet, but a lot of these could just go. The tool that I'm going to be using for this is called Sol Incinerator. Make sure you go to the correct URL. It's sol-incinerator.com. There's other tools that will do this as well, but this one works great. At this point, you already have your Solana wallet installed in your browser. Again, I'm using Phantom. And once that happens, you're going to be able to connect your wallet. Just come up here where it says Connect Wallet, click that. You'll get a pop-up and it will ask you what wallet you want to use. Again, I'm using Phantom. You use whatever you want to use. And it is detecting everything that it could potentially burn or get rid of. Now you see I have NFTs in here. Some of these, if I wanted to get rid of the NFT, I can get the rent back on those as well. But I'm going to leave those for now. And you may want to spend a little bit of time just going through this. You wouldn't want to accidentally burn something. And a lot of these things are just scams. Like these are scams. That's a scam. All of these are scams. And that's why it's very important to measure twice, cut once when you're in DeFi and crypto and Web3, because if you click the wrong thing, there's no turning back. If you accidentally burn the wrong asset, and it's just gonna be gone. There's nothing that I could do about it. There's nothing that you could do about it. There's no going back. This is Web3, this is DeFi. But you go over here to tokens, you see all these different tokens right here. These are the ones that I'm gonna probably just get rid of most of them today. These are all pretty much tokens that are dead in the ecosystem. Now, if I want to get rid of it, I can just click there, go through them. I'm gonna go through them one at a time, just one at a time, and make sure that it is the token that I want to get rid of, because if I burn this again, there's no coming back. But most of these are from a community project in the Gary Club ecosystem that got sunsetted, so there's no need to have these anymore. Okay, so I've selected different tokens that I want to basically get the rent back and burn. And one more time, double, triple check this because there is no going back. I can come over here and get 0.2055 Solana, which right now is roughly about $30. So I'm reclaiming about $30 worth of Solana just by reclaiming this rent fee. One cool thing about Sol Incinerator is you can come down here and pick the currency that you're going to be paid in. By default, it says Solana or wrapped Solana, or I could pick a stablecoin, USDC, $29.57. That's about $30 we were talking about. Or I can come down here and pick any of these other tokens. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pick Gary because that's an ecosystem that I am very bullish on. Now, I'm going to click that. It says that I'm going to get 382.899 Gary. And I could even come over here to Jupiter, which is a popular aggregator, and I could put in the 0.2055, and you can see it's gonna give me just about the same, 382.92 Gary, which is just about the same. There's always a little bit of fluctuation. Now I do have 103 items selected, so let's see if it will go through. If not, we might need to do this in chunks. So I'm gonna hit confirm burn, and it says it's gonna have two transactions. The first one is to claim Solana from the rent, and then the second one is to swap that Solana directly into whatever token you're choosing, and I'm doing Gary. I hit confirm. You'll get a pop-up like this. It's going a little slow, so it probably will need to be chopped up into a couple different chunks. Yes, see, we got this pop-up. It did say that there was a problem estimating the gas fee, so I would not click confirm. In this case, I would actually hit cancel, and I would go back, and I would actually select a smaller amount. So now I've selected about half as many, so it should go through now. Again, you could leave it as Solana, but I am going to pick a different coin. I'm going to search for Gary because that's the coin that I want to claim. Click Gary. And for this transaction, it's going to swap out 50 of the rent fees for 186.328 Gary. We could see we're going to get about the same amount of Gary on Jupiter through their aggregator as you would directly through Sol Incinerator. So I'm going to click confirm burn, and we're going to burn our first 50. It says there is going to be two transactions again, one for the burn and one to swap into our coin of choice. I'm gonna hit confirm, and we got our pop-up. And always double check the URL that you are signing with. It says sol-incinerator.com. Now we can go through here. It's gonna show all the ones that are gonna be burned. We can go through this list, but then we come down to the bottom. It's gonna give us 0.1 Solana. There is a small gas fee, so hit confirm. And once that goes through, you're gonna get another pop-up where it will ask you to swap Solana with Gary or whichever coin you are choosing, small gas fee, and hit confirm. And there you go, burn is complete. We reclaimed 186.32 Gary in exchange for our rent fee. And we could see in the wallet that it actually used the Jupiter aggregator in order to do this swap anyways. So I actually got the same exact price that I would have gotten otherwise. And if you enjoy these DeFi tips, tricks, and hacks, just go over to DeFiEarner.com. It's where I share a bunch of resources as well as do any of my DeFi giveaways. So I'm just going to go ahead and clean up the rest of whatever's in this wallet that I want to get rid of. But just remember that this is an easy way for you to reclaim different funds. You never know what rent is just sitting in your wallet that's not showing up in your balance that you can go in here and reclaim. If you have any questions about this, just drop them in the comments at youtube.com/@theblockchain. I do read and try to reply to as many comments as I can. You never know what funds are just lying around that you didn't even know that you already had. Also, if you want to keep this conversation going, you could jump into my Discord server at dunkmedia.club, where we're all passionate about making passive income with DeFi. Again, my name is Dunk. Keep creating, keep earning passive income with DeFi, and I will see you in the next video.